Eddie, to start off with, is just kind of explain, you know, to the floor, you know, what are the gaming mechanics that you can use in blockchain for casino and for sportsbook and for whatever particular gaming enterprise you're involved with, and how does that differentiate, and how can you use that technology? And also, can that be used for certain elements such as KYC, identity? It's obviously a big debate. I think there's two groups at the moment in crypto and blockchain, which is the, you know, very, very polar spectrum on the blockchain, which is the people that came out, blockchain's about decentralized, it's about taking the power back from people, it's about owning my data. And then there's the other side saying, well, actually, it's a technology that can be harnessed, centralized, and used and regulated. So, if you could just explain how your company engages with new technology that can, you know, it's different functionalities to the standard regulatory casino industry, and how it can help on that kind of, you know, regulatory kind of identification side of things.
Yeah, so I can answer that. So I think in terms of the benefits of the blockchain and the platform that we have in particular, we believe there's a very significant benefit for the gaming industry. And we believe that's across multiple stakeholders. That's the player, the operator, affiliates, game developers, or indeed regulators. And what you often hear is this term provably fair. We know the industry, I've heard it being talked about over the last 2 days, you know, has quite a significant image problem. Stats from UKGC, I think, suggest at the beginning of this year that 33% of UK consumers trust the operator that they gamble with, so the implication is two-thirds don't. And that's one of the biggest regulated markets in the world, with some of the biggest brands in the world on every high street. So I think blockchain is uniquely placed in terms of responsibility, in terms of trust, in terms of fairness, in terms of security, to address that image problem. And more often than not, it's an image problem, particularly in legislated markets. But there are cases where it's more than an image problem. It is a real problem. So we think blockchain, you know, has that very significant potential to impact the game industry. There are other aspects of that security. You know, players' funds are never held in the custody of the operator because it's held in escrow through a session, certainly with us on the FunFair platform. You can KYC once, so we have something called FunPass. We use traditional back-end KYC providers like Junio. Once you've done your KYC through our FunPass application, any other operator you go to can refer to that verified piece of KYC, and you don't have to KYC again. So we're removing a significant obstacle. The sign-up part is a lot easier. You get your winnings instantly because you haven't deposited as a player. From an operator perspective, costs are much lower. You have much lower infrastructure costs. Server infrastructure is much, much lower. You don't have chargebacks. There's significant savings in terms of headcount. There's security implications, and also for operators, those who are willing to join what is undoubtedly a disruptive technology revolution that's about to happen, can start on the very ground floor, and they can learn, and they can be seen as an innovator. This is an industry which I think we all beat ourselves up as being not particularly innovative. Well, this is innovative not just within the industry, this is innovative full stop. And there's very significant actually revenues already within the crypto audience who will be the first early adopters. There's some very simple dice games out there on the blockchain, so they could lethal roll, which people will be familiar with. That had over $350,000 bet on it in the last 24 hours. And there's other benefits for affiliates, for game developers, transparency, real-time payment. And you know, ultimately, we think it's a win-win-win, really, for consumers, for operators, and for regulators. So we take the regulatory piece very, very seriously. We have a background within the gaming industry. So we many steps, and having been on the operator side myself, let's not kid ourselves, this is still early days, okay, when we're talking about products that are still in their relative infancy. And there are some problems that need to be overcome with technology and other aspects, but you know, we firmly believe that there's certainly a lot of effort, a lot of resource going into overcoming those issues. Things like scalability and cost of core blockchains. But now is a great time if you're an operator who wants to get in early, wants to learn, wants to understand, you know, which benefits. We've had a few discussions around different points of view in terms of what benefits people think are going to resonate. It's provably fair, something that will resonate or not. We don't know, I think it's safe to say as a panel, but there's a whole series of benefits that the blockchain can bring, and now is the time to actually learn about those benefits and evolve them. So, you know, FunFair, we signed up our first partner. We'll be announcing that in the next week or so. We signed up two independent game developers who are developing games for our ecosystem. We'll be going out, we'll be looking for affiliate partners. So if you know you are interested in learning about this technology, getting in at a ground level and actually benefiting from it, not just immediately because there is a market there, you know, the nature of the crypto audience, the fact that they hold cryptocurrency, in my mind makes them a gambler in one sense anyway. And you can see on very, very basic products out there, there are significant sums of money being gambled as we speak now. So as a new product comes on tap, which is significantly better than anything that's out there, that becomes an immediate audience. And then I think you know, we'll see significant development and we'll begin to understand what the benefits are that will resonate with operators, consumers, affiliates, game developers, and regulators over the coming years.
So from that, you know, identification side and KYC, I think Vasily, we were talking about this, the GDPR is obviously a big, you know, discussion point at the moment in the industry, and there is obviously a debate internally within the crypto sphere, in the blockchain sphere about KYC, decentralized versus centralized. Can you tell us, you know, what the benefits of blockchain gaming are for KYC and GDPR, for example?
So I think, as per the gentleman, we've obviously acquired GDPR.